Somebody had told me that I should check out Coast to Coast AM today, and I signed up for the Coast to Coast thing, and they told me to listen to like the last 20 minutes of the episode. I'm gonna put it at the end of this, but I just wanted to say that, working in 5D, things seem to finally be making their way to where I wanted them to be. If Coast to Coast is talking about it and it's really, really getting to the forefront, then that means that we're finally getting somewhere, or at least the plan is working the way it needs to be, because they talk about a lot of really interesting stuff. I think Michael Sala talks about how he loves Q, but he also talks about how the mainstream media is attacking it and stuff, and I see that he gets that this shit's happening, and I guess he doesn't see why it has to happen to the Q team in order to expose it, because then, I'm a hunter setting a trap. You're setting the traps for the big ones that are gonna come up and come censor people so you can identify who they are, because they're gonna wanna show off their trophy, so to speak. So it's interesting to hear George Noory kind of be a little very, or be very, in the middle on the whole thing while he's listening to all these guys. And it's so crazy, at the very last little bit of it, some guy comes in and he was like, "I'll tell you QAnon in 30 seconds." And I was like, "Oh shit." And he comes out swinging. He's like, "Cicada 3301, Microchip, Defango. Go watch Defango's channel. He's got all the videos." And they release all the other videos saying this and that and this and that, with all of, iOS script. And he was like, "This shit's in the bag." And I was like, "Holy crap. Holy crap." I mean, he even called out Dustin Nemos, as and a couple other people being like, "Yo, if you're not toeing the line with Q, you're basically a charlatan," or whatever, these guys are like coming after you. And I was just like, "Holy crap, did they just say that shit on Coast to Coast?" So what are we gonna see? Yeah, we're definitely gonna see a lot of Q people, and probably Q's gonna have to mention something about that, because it's Coast to Coast, like, that's massive. My name got mentioned on Coast to Coast. Maybe we'll get some new subs. Maybe we'll get some more subs. George Noory and Coast to Coast people. I would love to come on and talk to you guys about this very, very, coolly, respectfully, all that, because there's a lot of things that need to be done. And I think that that's actually the platform where I think the information that we have might do the most. Because it's funny, he was talking about Roswell. I was just in Roswell looking up stuff about UFOs and aliens and stuff. Isn't it weird that all of a sudden, right after I'm there, Q's posting about it? Same thing with the Sunspot Observatory thing. It's almost like he forgot he posted stuff that very, very similarly matched it back in the day. I don't know who's doing the shit now, but I do know what the point was, and this might actually be the best course of action for the futures, to release it the correct way to everyone else, so people really truly understand why it was done. And maybe we can take that division and put it back into unity. So we're gonna go ahead and put the rest of that thing at the very end of this, and let me know what you think in the comments below. If you like what we do and you want to see more stuff like that, hit the like button, subscribe, share this with your friends. If you want to donate stuff, check us out, patreon.com/Defango or streamlabs.com/Defango. Either way, much love, and definitely listen to this.
Let's go to Carrie in Bettendorf, Iowa, east of the Rockies. Hi, Carrie.
Oh, George, I am so excited to speak with you. I actually got to meet you in Chicago a few years ago at a function,
Yeah.
and you were so kind to take a picture with me, and you really seem to care about your fans,
I
and
bet
I
I
just
look
love
the
that.
same, or did I age? Who knows?
No, you look exactly the same. But
Great.
we are living in such exciting times, and I have been following Q since the very beginning.
Have you? Okay. What did you
Yeah.
think in the beginning about Q?
Well, there's been a few things that kind of raised, I try to look at everything with a critical eye. And like those photos of the president's desk on Air Force One, it's like set up for a left-handed president, and we know Barack Obama was left-handed. If you look at where the pens and things are sitting,
Right.
and paraphernalia has been banned from Trump rallies. They're making people turn their shirts inside out. And, I'm wondering if Mr. Sala is aware that this QAnon group, was thrown off of Reddit for making violent threats, and that's why they were forced to move the vote.
Yeah, that's true.
I really don't think that anyone from the Trump administration would send people to this vote website that's just rampant with racism and anti-Semitism. And I'm wondering if he saw the NBC article that named the scammers behind QAnon. They're far from military intelligence. They're con artists, and they're hurting people both emotionally and financially. And this is very irresponsible to have it on the air.
Michael, go ahead.
Well, I think that what happened on the Reddit forum, I did go to that forum and get a lot of information, and I never found anything there that was promoting violence or anything.
They did
like
get
that.
Bounced, though.
They did get bounced, and that was because I think that they were becoming just very, very popular. And as I said, I didn't see anything there that was racist or that was promoting hatred or that was in any way kind of like beyond the pale.
But that's what Reddick cited to get them bounced off.
They did get them bounced off. They did bounce them, and you know, presumably because they were violating some terms of service in terms of behavior. But as I said, I never saw that, and a lot of the people that were on that forum didn't do anything any remotely like that. And, you know, there's a lot of forums. I mean, the forums, it's kind of like the Wild West often. And to kind of bounce an entire thread or subreddit forum there, that was kind of very unusual. But, you know, what I found very interesting was the number of newspaper articles talking about the QAnon discussion threads on Reddit being banned. And that, you know, the number of articles basically did kind of support one of the things that QAnon has been saying, is that the mainstream media around most of them get talking points faxed to them or emailed to them around 4 a.m. in the morning, and that way when the reporters get up, they have kind of like stories that they just kind of write up using these talking points, which kind of reflects a lot of the times in these kind of like critiques of the Q information, that this is not independent journalism kind of like investigating the QAnon phenomenon. This is a bunch of journalists getting talking points sent to them by the deep state to take out the QAnon movement. So I'm very, very suspicious of this kind of coordinated mainstream media attacks on the kind of like legitimacy of the Q information, and as I said, you know, just more most recently, the fact that QAnon knew that that Trump was speaking to the heads of government of Britain and Australia, that Q knew about this in advance and revealed that in advance, you know, says that this is someone working within the within the administration. As for the vote .co forum, I really don't know enough about it to comment on that, but certainly it's a place where people can freely express their opinion, and it's like the Wild West, and people will say, you know, pretty nasty things about one another, but apparently this is where you can share your information without being banned, and it's one of the few places now that you can do that.
Let's go to first-time caller Doug in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Douglas, go ahead, sir.
Dr. Michael, and why not? Dr. George, right? You've been doing this long enough.
Okay, my honorary doctor.
That's it. I'll give it to you right now.
You got it.
Hey, I wanted to call in because I actually saw this show popping up on Twitter, and I'm one of the few people that knows about not only the genesis about this, but I am one of the people that the journalists that did these stories on them came to me to get the information on it.
Uh-huh.
So it's
okay.
Not coming from the deep state. I'm a former contributor for various news agencies. I still work now as a contributing editor and a ghostwriter. And back in March, I started saying, when a lot of these things started, I started to talk about what the genesis was. There was going to be a media blitz, and eventually these guys are going to come under scrutiny. But a little bit better here, because I'm a big critic of the Q thing. And the last caller is, they're touching on some serious concerns here. It's not just that they got banned off Reddit. They've had four members now arrested recently, one for setting a wildfire, one for an armed standoff at the Hoover Dam. These are all QAnon people What was the last one was a YouTuber threatened a mass shooting at YouTube, and I forget what the fourth one was. They've not only just been banned from Reddit, they've been thrown off of Zazzle. Amazon's about to pull them. The Android store has pulled their app, and Vote is probably the most toxic place on the internet next to 8chan. But I know about the creation of this, if you guys want to know.
Yeah, how much time do we have? We only have a few minutes left.
I could do it in 60 seconds.
Go for it.
Great. It started off, it came out of a group called Cicada 3301, and an operator on the internet, an extremely elusive one by the name of Microchip, who's known for being able to twist social sites to his own whim. He did it with Twitter. It was national news. He's done it with other campaigns. They came up with this idea, and there was a YouTuber by the name of Defango who said, wouldn't it be a great idea to act as an intel agent, make some vague statements, and then watch it blow up, and we'll push it from behind. Microchip has come out of the shadows. He's released not only the chat logs, but when they came out and said the chat logs were bogus, he released a real-time video of his iOS device opening up the chats, a web browser, the main home screen functions. It's exactly what it is, and then you refer back to Defango's videos at the beginning of creating Q, and he's on YouTube, and those videos only have a couple hundred views, and he's saying, watch this QAnon thing. We're going to push this. It's going to be huge, and that's exactly what the chat logs say. After that, it was taken from 4chan and brought over to 8chan. Somebody jacked it because it was an anonymous person. Nobody could come up and claim it. After that, it turned into a merchandising operation. If you see, as of tonight, people in the community like Dustin Nemos are making hit lists for people that are not willing to toe the line on Q. I've offered all the images come from the public. They are public images, ones that are put up like on the AP website or AFP, the ones that are never used for news stories but are available for purchase. All of them are in the public domain. I've offered cash. I told the guy I'd sell my McLaren and give him the cash if he could prove any of the statements came out before, they are true, valid, precise, or if any of the pictures are not in the public domain. So far, all they've been is attacked, blocked, and
interesting. Let's get Michael's take. Doug, very efficient there. What do you think, Michael?
Well, I think when we look at the role of the mainstream media in, you know, not only with the Q phenomenon, but also the Trump administration, I think there is a lot of evidence that there is a lot of coordination between the mainstream media that does have talking points sent to them to kind of like attack the Trump administration on a whole host of issues. One of the things that really was very evident was that when during the Trump rally in Tampa, Florida, and you had a lot of Q signs that were held up, the mass media kind of went into a meltdown saying that this was just a bunch of radicals, alt-right fanatics doing all sorts of nasty things in various public sites. But really it was just a bunch of people showing that they believe that the QAnon phenomenon is very real and that this is a very closely associated with the Trump administration. And, you know, I mean, certainly the QAnon information does support Donald Trump to an extent that makes a lot of people feel very uncomfortable. I know that you know, there are a lot of people that have liberal progressive views, and I'm one of them. I have liberal progressive views, but you know, when it comes to the deep state, unlike a lot of liberal progressives who kind of like dismiss the existence of a deep state, you know, because of my research on exopolitics, the cover-up of extraterrestrial life, secret space programs, the deep state is very, very real, and it does control the mass media, and the mass media does get talking points sent to them on a number of issues that the deep state wants action to be taken on. Operation Mockingbird is very real. It was run. This is something that emerged during the church committee talk. So, yes, I think we need to kind of like keep an open mind. Things are going to kind of like be revealed over the next couple of weeks with this whole kind of Rosenstein. You know, whether he's sacked or
in or out, yeah, or he may quit on his own.
Well, that's right, and that seems to be the catalyst. You know, what the Q movement has been saying, that once Rosenstein goes, then all of these sealed indictments are going to be unsealed, and that's, you know, if that happens, then Great.
Well, we need this thing to end once and for all, Michael. My God, how long has it been going on now?
Well, you know, there's a lot of division in the United States, unfortunately. It's very toxic politically. I saw it happen with the Obama administration in how the kind of right...
But it was never this bad. I mean, this is a divided country right now.
It is very divided, and I'm hoping that the truth will come out on a number of issues, and I think once the truth comes out, that then it'll wake people up. And, you know, there's a lot of kind of red pilling that needs to happen here, and hopefully it'll happen with Q, but certainly I know, you know, with the disclosure movement, it can happen there. Maybe it'll happen with Antarctica.